like you to amplify on the fact that racing now is the number one spectator sport.
Racing is a sport that people attend for its intrinsic entertainment value and action value. And I think few people realize the scope of the short tracks. Tracks like this running weekly across the country represent about 85% of racing's annual attendance.
Midget racing is a contact sport as well as a good competitive sport. And we enjoy, you might say, some bumping and rubbing. And that's really what they make bumpers for. We don't mind bumping and rubbing. But crashing is another matter. We don't like intentional shoves into the wall, intentional boots from the rear or from the front.
The midgets. For the spectator, it's certainly a lot of fun to watch, and many call this the most spectacular of all auto racing.
It's something you have to have very quick reflexes. The cars are quick and devilish, and they maneuver a great deal. As you can see, they're moving back and forth, jockeying for position, moving up, racing one another very closely. The midgets are small and very light, and on a track like this, it does become very physical. It's a situation where you've got to work very hard to maintain control of that car.
Are we going to watch a situation here today where a driver who asserts himself can then win the race?
Competition is so much higher now than I think it even was last year, and again, you still need that chili bowl luck. So I'm still trying to find that proverbial rabbit that is running around here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I know there's one over the fairgrounds, I just don't know where they're buried at.
If I could win the drill, it'll be pretty special. Somebody might get the helmet if I throw it into the crowd, something. It'll be something that they don't forget, because I'll never forget it. It'd be pretty amazing and a blessing for sure.
Doesn't pay a lot to run second. Nobody really cares who runs second here, so you kind of keep that mindset, and hopefully whoever you might have to root knows that too.
Yeah, it'd be huge. You definitely got to get through your preliminary night to have a shot at winning Saturday night and start up front. You know, I started 13th last year and got to third and spun out, so this year that won't be happening. And you know, there's 320 cars, so it'd be unbelievable for me to win this race.
What would one more mean to you?
I'd mean that I got number six, that's for sure. Nobody's even close to that.
We'll be right back.
pretty upset about it, and kind of, you know, in the mood of thinking he was done and he was screwed. So, you know, just kind of had to stop and you're fine. You know, I did it last year. Larson did it last night. You'll be okay. Just the biggest thing is don't get in a hurry. You know, try not to eliminate yourself in those races more than it actually is trying to pass cars. You know, to finish first, you must finish.